Hi everyone, welcome to Friday's English lesson. So first of all, I would like you please to write today's date and skill into your catch-up book. So today's date is Friday the 22nd of January 2021, and your skill, sorry it's a bit of a long one today, is to edit the or and spelling into your using look, say, cover, write, check. I'll just say that again because I got that wrong. Edit or and spelling using look, say, cover, write, check. So you can pause the video and write that into your book now. Okay. First of all then, well done for all of your hard work this week to write your brilliant biographies about Tim Peake. We are very proud of all of you. Everyone at school is incredibly proud of all the work you've been doing. I know it's tricky, I know it's really tough to juggle everything, especially when your adults at home are working as well, but you really are doing a great job, everyone at home, so please be proud of yourselves, because we are really proud of you guys too. So today then, we are going to be practicing some spellings and using our new skills to edit a piece of writing. So, task one. Today we are going to be focusing on three sounds when we are editing our spelling. Now, they're all sounds that we've covered already this year, so we're just recapping some of the stuff that we've already talked about, so it shouldn't be anything totally new to anyone. So the first sound we're going to look at is the or sound, the AU spelling of the or sound. Then we're also going to look at the OR spelling of the or sound. I know there is also the AW, but we're not looking at that one today. We're just going to be looking at these two. And finally, this spelling, it's just on its own, it's the curly k, 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 k. But we're going to be looking at today spelling it and creating the s sound. So again, we talked a lot about this in lessons before Christmas, the s sound with the curly k. And so we're just going to be revising that today. So our first task, we are going to have a go at spelling some words using these three sounds. So I will show you the word and you will read it out loud. Once you've done that, you're then going to have a go at writing it down. And finally, it will then come back up onto the PowerPoint and you will check it. And you can give yourself a tick if you got it right. And if you didn't quite get it right, you can correct it. So don't rub it out, just leave it as your first attempt. And next to it, you can write the correct spelling. And we'll do a different spelling, for new spelling, new line. It will be the easiest way to lay this out. We've just talked about that already. Okay, so your first one today, can you please have a go at reading this word out loud? Okay, if you needed a little bit more time on that, you can pause the video. This word is autumn. Autumn, so think about which sound is it that we're using of our three sounds, which sound can you spot in this word? Okay, now I would like you please, underneath your date and skill, to have a go at writing that into your book. So you can pause the video and write that in. Okay, now it's time to check it again. So you can pause the video and double check you got it right if you need to. We will just be repeating this pattern, so just feel free to pause the video whenever you need to. Again, if you got it right, give it a tick, well done. And if you just made a little mistake, then you can just write it on the same line next to it, the correct spelling, and you can come back to that later if you want to have another practice. Well done, right. The next one then. Can you have a go at reading this word out loud? Okay, so if you need a little bit longer, you can pause the video. Hopefully you will recognise this one from this week. It is the word astronaut. So it's got the AU spelling of that OR sound. Okay, well done. Now I would like you please to pause the video and have a go at writing that on the next line into your catch-up book. Well done. Now you can correct it or tick it if you got it right. Pause the video and double check it. Well done. Here is our next word. So have a go at reading this out loud. Don't try and do it in your head. Make sure you sound it out loud. Okay, this is the word automobile. So that is another fancy word for a car. So it's got the AU or sound at the beginning of the word. Right, you know what to do. Pause the video and have a go at writing that one down. Right, now you can double check it. Give it a tick or correct it on the line next to it. Well done. Well done. Right, have a go at this one then. So that is the word August. So as we all know, August is a month in the middle of the year that is normally in the middle of summer. It's during the summer holidays. So again, it's got that AU sound at the beginning. It's got to have a capital letter, the word August. Right, you can have a go at writing that one down then. Pause the video if you need to. Okay, double check it for me. Remember, give yourself a tick or you can correct it on the next line. Right, here we go then. Let's have a go at this word. So there's a little clue in that picture in the corner. So this word is the word launch, launch, launch. So we've again got that AU spelling of the OR sound and it is in the middle of the word this time. Right, pause the video and you can have a go at writing that one out. Well done. Right, can you please correct it for me or give yourself a tick if you got that one right. Good job. Okay, here is the next one. Can you have a go at reading this one out loud? Notice that the block has changed colour. So that word is corner, corner, corner. But this time we've got slightly different spelling of the word, of the OR sound, haven't we? It's the OR spelling this time. And again, it is in the middle of the word. So I would like you know what to do, pause the video now and have a go at writing down the word corner. Well done, right, you can double check it, give yourself a tick or you can correct it. Well done. Let's have a go at this one. Remember, read it out loud, sound it out, pause the video if you need to. Okay, so that word is normal. Normal. What is normal? That's a question for another day, I think. So again, with the OR spelling of the OR sound, can you please have a go at sounding and writing that one down? Sounding it out and writing it down. Right, pause the video if you need a little bit longer. You can double check it now. Give yourself a big tick if you got it right, or you can write the correct spelling next to it. Well done. Again, we've changed colour slightly now. Well, not slightly, it's a completely different colour. So can you have a go at reading this one out loud? Pause the video if you need to. So that is the word space. So we've got our split digraph A here. And again, this curly cur, it's not a k, is it? Because otherwise it would be sp, ache, spake. That's not a real word, is it? So we know that that's got to be a s sound. So it is the word space. You should all be pros at this one after this week, but can you have a go at writing that one on the next line for me? Pause the video. Right, well done. So now you can double check it, give yourself a big tick if you got it right, and if not, you can just write it correctly. Pause the video if you need to. Well done. Let's have a go at this one then. Can you sound that one out? Well done, that is the word face. Again, it's got the s sound in the curly cur. So you know what to do. Can you have a go at writing that one down for me? Pause the video if you need to. Well done. Now you can double check it, give yourself a big tick, or you can correct it next to it, the word face. Good job, let's have another one. I wonder which sound this one's going to be. Pause the video and have a go at reading that one. Remember to do it out loud, sound it out if you need to. Okay, now you can have a go at writing it down. That was the word place, place. Pause the video if you need to. Okay, here is the word place. Can you double check it? Did you get it correct? Big tick. If not, that's fine. You can just write it next to it. Good job. Okay, let's have a go at this one out loud then. Pause the video. Okay, that is the word centre. So this time, the curlica, the s sound, is at the beginning of the word, isn't it? because Kenta would sound a bit strange. So it is the word center. Well done. Can you please have a go at writing that one down? Pause the video for me. Remember to do it on the next line. Okay, center. Double check it. Did you get it correct? Give yourself a tick. If not, you know what to do. Correct it on the line. Pause the video if you need to. Good job. Last one then. I wonder which sound this is going to be. Okay, pause the video. Can you read that one for me? Okay, so this is the word raced. So we've got our root word race and our suffix on the end. But because race already ends with an E, we just need to add the D. So it's raced. Raced. So we've got the C, the S in the middle of the word. Right, pause the video. Have a go at writing that one down. Okay. Did you get it right? Give yourself a tick if you did. If not, correct it on the same line. You can just pause the video if you need a little bit longer. Well done. Okie doke. Right, task two then. So now you have practiced your spelling. We've looked at all three of those different sounds. If you'd like to just pause the video now and go back and double check any of the ones you didn't quite get right on your first attempt, if you'd like to have another practice, you can do the same thing, say it out loud. Cover it with your hand, write it down, double check it. Did I get it right? If you did, fantastic. If not, you can have another go. If you are finished with that and you want to move on to the next task, I would like you please to have a go at putting one word from each of the three sounds that we've looked at into a sentence underneath your spelling practice. Okay, so same piece of work on the same page if you've got space. So here are some of my examples. I said, my favourite season is autumn. Can you spot which sound that words that sentence has got in it? Which one was I using? It was the or, A-U, or sound from autumn. Well done. I live around the corner. Which sound have I got in that sentence? So in corner, I've got the O-R, or sound, haven't I? So it's the or again, the O-R, or sound. And finally, you have some chocolate on your face. Ah, oh, lucky you. Been eating nice chocolate. So what sound have I used in that one? Well done if you spotted the sound in the curly cut in face. We've got a k there that's actually a k though, haven't we? So it's tricky, that sound. Okay, well done. So now you can pause the video and choose three words, one from each sound that we've talked about. It's all written in your book, so you shouldn't need to go back through the video, but you can if you want to double check and then put that word. So double check the spelling and put that word into a sentence at the bottom of your spellings. Pause the video and off you go. Okay, well done for completing task two. We're now going to move on to task three. This is our final task of the day. If you have got a printer and you'd like to print it out, as always, it's on the website underneath this video. If not, you can just copy this into your book. If you are running out of time and you don't finish the whole of this activity, if you only get half done, please don't worry. Obviously, if we were in school, we'd just stop for lunch or playtime or the next lesson. So same thing now. Please don't worry if you're running out of time. It's great. Okay, so your final task today is to apply the skills that you have been practicing by editing this paragraph. There are some words that are spelled incorrectly. So if you've printed it out, you can use a different coloured pencil to correct the spellings that you spot. And if you are copying it down, you can just correct them as you go, and you might like to underline it just to highlight the word. As a top tip, they are all words that you will have practiced at the beginning. So I'm not asking you to check any other words. They are all there for you to double check, and they are all using those three sounds. So we will have a quick read through it together, so you know, just in case you don't quite understand, because they are spelt in an interesting way. So, last autumn, my friend Jimmy and I saw something fall from space, so we ran around the corner to see what it was. I could see the shock on Jimmy's face when what looked like an astronaut stepped out of the automobile. It's a flying car, Jimmy shouted. We felt astonished. The engine didn't feel normal, so I needed to find a place to land. I lost control of the car but ended up in the centre of this field. Do you know where I am? Asked the strange man. You're at the Churchill School, Jimmy replied. I'll get Mrs. Stone to come and help us. Just then, Mrs. Stone raced outside to see what was going on. Don't worry, she said, I've got an idea. A few months later, in August, we were back on the field. Mrs. Stone had fixed the flying car and we were about to launch it back into the sky. Thank you, said the man. I've had a lovely time with you all, but I can't wait to be flying again. 3, 2, 1, we all shouted, lift off! Okay, so that is your paragraph. Well, it's really more than a paragraph. That's your short story that you can write into your book if you've got time, or you can just edit it if you want to print it out. Okay, I think that is it from me. Oh, plenary. Last thing, read back through your biography. So if you finish all of that, your final challenge is to see if you can take your skills from today and put them into your biography. If you spot any spelling mistakes of the words that we've been looking at, you can correct them just like we would in school with your green pen. I know you've had a lot of tasks to do today, so don't panic if you're running out of time, but this is just a final task, final thought for anyone who would like to have a go at this. So yeah, see if you can edit your own biography using the spellings that we have discussed today. Okay, that is it from me now. Have a lovely rest of your day if I don't see you virtually. Take care and I will speak to you soon. Goodbye.